Hello, my Flufferschnoots. We're trying something a little bit different today. Have the microphones positioned differently, and I have the gain on 100%. It picks up everything. You'd think I'd live in like a jungle or something with all of the animal noises going on outside. But I've got a pile of cables in front of me. And I found that cables can make some really, really nice noises. I'm also wearing this jacket. This jacket will kind of be a background thing, but you'll probably hear it. You'll definitely hear these cables, though. This one is a flat Ethernet cable. Haven't used it yet, so it's still kind of in this wrapper that I'm struggling to remove it from. I'm probably going to leave the bird noises in this one. And you guys, if you want, you can tell me what you think of it. I don't really mind them. But, you know, if you tune into a video just to hear one noise and there's other noises going on in the background, sometimes that kind of sucks. The next is a standard power cable for like a computer power supply or something. Another one I'm having a struggle. This has a like a little wire tie. This is a very thick cable with lots of copper and insulation. These cables usually are. It's a little bit harder to breathe into the Beta 58. But since the SM57 doesn't have a pop filter, this is apparently another computer power cable. This one is like huge. It is 1.3 millimeters. I think that's what that says. It's hard to read it because it's like carved into the cable. Mentioned before that the SM57 has like a floating capsule. I don't know if that's what it's called, but I've bumped it in a couple of videos and it doesn't sound that bad. This is what it sounds like if I touch it. Yeah, I don't know. It's just kind of a weird noise. I don't know if I like it. Touching the beta sounds much better. Because it's just like a mesh. To move so slow and so cautiously, because if I even touch the desk, it sounds like I'm dropping like a piano on it or something. These are very sensitive. This is a plastic bag. And there are two Ethernet cables in here. I need one of these, actually. I don't know how that happened. Ooh, wow, this is a heavy-duty one. We're not here for plastic bag sounds. If you guys want to hear plastic bags, you can let me know. I don't think that I could do plastic bags with the gain on 100% because this is really intense. I'm going to carefully take it out. Here's one of the Ethernet cables. This is another flat cable. I got this because I wanted to run cable in my studio, but I never did because I'm lazy. It's a Cat 6 cable, it looks like. man, this is gonna be really tangled when I'm done with it. I think I'm done with it right now. The other cable that's in here is just a standard round Ethernet cable. Data cable Cat5e. It's got these little clippies. They have a different pitch. Also has this little, barcode tag thing on it. I don't know why. I'm not sure where this even came from. That's enough of this cable. Now I've got this. Let's put the bag away. I can't put the bag away without putting you in it. Next side. That's enough of the paper bag, plastic bag. Now I have just another Cat 5, I think. I don't know what these are. They transfer internet from the wall to my computer. I mean, honestly, I don't really care what they are, because they do transfer the internet from the wall to my computer. I've already heard sounds like this a couple times, so I think I'm going to move on from this. I don't even think the plastic ends will make noises. No, because they have, like, the covers on them so they don't break, so they don't really make noise. Alright, now it's time for probably my favorite trigger out of all of these ones. Now, I got the idea for this from ASMR Surge. He has this absolutely incredible video where he opens a Commodore computer from the 80s. And it sounds so just awesome. And the parts that I like the most are the power cable, which I don't think this one is going to make quite the same noise. And when he rubs his hand across the cassette tapes, it's just a really, really unique sound that I haven't heard anywhere else. I'm going to try and make similar cable noises. So this one has a power adapter. This just arrived in the mail yesterday. This is a gigantic AC power adapter for my Lenovo Legion. It's a 230 watt with 20 volt output. This is like the biggest power adapter I've ever seen, and it's really heavy. Take this power cord and plug it in. The body of this is kind of like ridged, or maybe ribbed. bigger and without making too much noise. Need a better grip on it though. Sure, this will work. Of the power cable that actually connects to the computer is like really thin, and it doesn't make a good noise when it touches the actual power adapter. That's gonna wrap this one up. So, Audacity says I've been recording for about 27 minutes. You can look at the length of this video and see how much I had to edit. I suspect it's gonna be a pretty good amount. Because with the gain up so high, it picks up everything. Which is good and bad, I suppose. There's not a lot of sound dampening material in this room, because the natural reverb is really good for music. So it's just kind of something I gotta work with. I guess before we go, I can blow at you. Let me set this down. The table, it rattles the mic stand, which has the springs on it. I don't know if you can hear that, but that was really weird. Alright. I'm gonna move the mics closer together. And here we go.
this isn't a blowing on the microphone video. So we're going to end it here. As always, let me know what you think of these triggers. Everything on this channel is just a big experiment to see what it sounds like. But that's it. We hit the 30-minute mark on my side. I hope you all are feeling a little bit more relaxed and generally just better. I'll see you again on the next one. Bye-bye.